Good morning. Today we are going to talk about the temporal and infratemporal fossa. At the end of the session, you should be able to tell about the boundaries and contents of temporal fossa, boundaries and contents of infratemporal fossa, boundaries and contents of pterygopalatine fossa, muscles of mastication, its origin, insertion, nerve supply and action, the relations of lateral pterygoid muscle, the accessory muscles of mastication, how to test the muscles of mastication, applied anatomy, and last but not the least, the assignment. Coming to the temporal fossa. Boundaries. Anteriorly, the zygomatic bone and the frontal bone. Superiorly and posteriorly, the superior temporal line. Inferiorly, the zygomatic arch. The floor is formed by the pterion, which comprises of the frontal bone, the antero-inferior angle of parietal bone, the squamous part of the temporal bone, and the greater wing of the sphenoid. The contents are the temporalis muscle, the deep temporal nerve, and the deep temporal artery. Now we are talking about the infratemporal fossa. The boundaries. Anteriorly, posterior surface of the body of maxilla. The roof is formed by the infratemporal surface of the greater wing of sphenoid. The medial wall is formed by the lateral pterygoid plate and the pyramidal process of palatine bone. The lateral wall is formed by the ramus of mandible. Coming to the contents, there are two muscles, that is the lateral and medial pterygoid muscle, mandibular nerve and its branches, maxillary nerve and its branches, which include the posterior superior alveolar nerve, the cauda tympani branch of the facial nerve, maxillary artery, mainly its two parts, the first and second parts and its branches. Next, the pterygopalatine fossa. Boundaries. Anteriorly, the posterior surface of maxilla. Posteriorly, the pterygoid process and greater wing of sphenoid. Medially, the perpendicular plate of palatine bone. Floor, the union of anterior and posterior walls. Coming to the contents, the maxillary nerve and its branches, the pterygopalatine ganglia and its branches, the third part of maxillary artery. The muscles of mastication. All the muscles of mastication develop from the first branchial arch and hence supplied by the mandibular nerve. We have the accessory muscle of mastication, that is the digastric muscle, the anterior belly of digastric is developed from the first branchial arch, hence supplied by the mandibular nerve. The posterior belly developed from the second branchial arch and hence supplied by the facial nerve. So coming to the primary muscles of mastication, that is the masseter, temporalis, lateral pterygoid and medial pterygoid. The secondary muscles are mylohyoid, geniohyoid and digastric. So the main muscles of mastication all develop from the first pharyngeal arch, hence supplied by the mandibular nerve. They are the masseter, temporalis, medial pterygoid and lateral pterygoid. Masseter, it comprises of three layers: superficial, middle and deep layers. The superficial layer arises from the anterior two-thirds of the lower border of the zygomatic arch. It is inserted to the lower part of the lateral surface of the rhombus of mandible. The middle layer arises from the posterior one-third of the lower border of the zygomatic arch. It is inserted to the middle part of the rhombus of mandible. The deep layer arises from the deep surface of the zygomatic arch. It is inserted to the upper part of the rhombus and coronoid process of the mandible. It is supplied by the masseteric branch of the mandibular nerve. Action: it elevates the mandible, this muscle may become overdeveloped due to undue chewing, that is called as bruxism. The parotid gland lies superficial to this muscle. The muscle may become hypertrophied, so this may shut off the flow of the parotid gland. Temporalis muscle, it's a fan-shaped muscle, very large muscle and very powerful muscle. It contains fibers which are vertical and horizontal, and it is often visible when chewing. So it originates from the temporal fossa and temporal fascia. It is inserted to the coronoid process and anterior border of the rhombus of mandible. It is supplied by the deep temporal branches of mandibular nerve. Action: anterior and superior fibers help in elevation of the mandible, while the posterior fibers helps in retraction of the protruded mandible. The medial pterygoid muscle has two heads, the superficial head and deep head. Superficial head arises from the maxillary tuberosity. The deep head arises from the medial surface of the lateral pterygoid plate. It is inserted to the roughened area on the medial surface of the rhombus of the mandible below the mandibular foramen. It is supplied by the nerve to medial pterygoid, which arises from the main trunk of the mandibular nerve. Action: it elevates the mandible and protrudes the mandible. Unilateral contraction causes side-to-side movement of the mandible. So it is most commonly involved in myofascial pain dysfunction syndrome. So trismus, falling inferior alveolar nerve block, is mainly due to involvement of the medial pterygoid muscle. Lateral pterygoid muscle, it is a key muscle of the muscles of mastication because many structures are related to it. This is a short conical muscle which has two heads, the upper and lower heads. The upper head, it arises from the infratemporal surface of the crust of the greater wing of sphenoid. The lower head arises from the lateral surface of the lateral pterygoid plate. Coming to its insertion, it has a three-point insertion. Number one, the pterygoid fovea. Number two, the articular disc. Number three, the capsule of the temporomandibular joint. It is supplied by the anterior division of the mandibular nerve. Action. So this is one muscle which helps in depresses the mandible. So it helps in opening the mandible, whereas other muscles helps in closing the mandible. Along with medial pterygoid, it helps in protruding the mandible. So unilateral contraction causes the lateral movement of the mandible to the opposite side. Coming to the relations, the superficial relations are masseter, ramus of the mandible, and maxillary artery. Deep relations are mandibular nerve, middle meningeal artery, sphenomandibular ligament, medial pterygoid muscle. Relations of the upper border are deep temporal nerves and massetric nerve. Structures related to the lower border are the lingual nerve, inferior alveolar nerve, and middle meningeal artery. Structures passing between the two heads are the maxillary artery and the buccal branch of mandibular nerve. Structures surrounding the lateral pterygoid are the pterygoid, plexus of veins. So this muscle is most commonly involved in myofascial pain dysfunction syndrome. Unilateral failure of lateral pterygoid muscle to contract results in deviation of the mandible towards the affected side on opening. Bilateral failure results in limited opening, loss of protrusion, and loss of full lateral deviation. Coming to the accessory muscles of mastication, the digastric muscle has two bellies, anterior and posterior belly, Antebellum develops from first arch, hence supplied by mandibular nerve. The posterior belly develops from second arch, hence supplied by facial nerve. The antebellum arises from the digastric fossa present in the mandible. The posterior belly arises from the mastoid notch of the temporal bone. Both are inserted to a common intermediate tendon, which is in turn attached or fixed to the junction between body and greater carno of the hyoid bone. So the anterior belly and posterior belly. Anterior belly develops from the first arch, supplied by mandibular nerve. The posterior belly develops from the second arch, hence supplied by the facial nerve. Anterior belly, it is taking origin from the digastric fossa present in the mandible, while the posterior belly from the mastoid notch of temporal bone. They are inserted to a common intermediate tendon, which is fixed to the junction between body and greater corner of the hyoid bone. So action, it depresses the mandible while opening the mouth. But if the mandible is fixed, it elevates the hyoid bone during swallowing. Coming to the mylohyoid muscle, this muscle also develops from the first branchial arch, hence supplied by the mylohyoid branch of the inferior alveolar nerve, which is in turn a branch of the mandibular nerve. So origin, it arises from the mylohyoid line of the mandible. It is the posterior fibers are inserted to the body of the hyoid bone, while the middle and anterior fibers decussate to form a fibrous band. So it depresses the mandible while opening the mouth. But if the mandible is fixed, it elevates the hyoid bone and floor of the mouth during deglutition. Geniohyoid, it arises from the inferior genial tubercles of the mandible. It is inserted to the anterior surface of the hyoid bone. It is supplied by the C1 fibers to the hypoglossal nerve. For details, kindly read the ansa cervicalis. Action, it depresses the mandible while opening the mouth, or if the mandible is fixed, it elevates the hyoid bone. So testing the muscles of mastication, so these muscles has to be palpated simultaneously, both on the right and left side, by using the palmar surface of the middle, index and four fingers. If there is no pain, the muscle is healthy, but if there is pain, there must have been some injury. So to test the temporalis, placing the fingers bilaterally above the zygomatic arch in front of the temporomandibular joint and asking the patient to clench his teeth. So you can feel the contraction of the temporalis muscle. To test the masseter muscle, so placing the fingers below the zygomatic arch in front of the temporomandibular joint and asking the patient to clench his teeth, can feel the contraction of the masseter muscle. To test the medial pterygoid, This is by using the intraoral method. So placing the fingers lingually and by applying pressure at the insertion of the muscle above the angle of the mandible. Similarly, the lateral pterygoid also is tested orally. The superior head, by applying equal pressure on the lateral poles of the condyle as the patient opens and closes his mouth. Similarly, the inferior head, by placing the forefinger on the buccal area of the maxilla, third molar region, and to slide on the medial direction behind the maxillary tuberosity. Apart from this, you can contract or stretch by protruding against resistance, so pain will increase in case of inferior lateral pterygoid injury. So stretching where you can clench the teeth increases the pain, but by placing a separator and clenching the teeth there is no pain. Test the superior lateral pterygoid. So on contraction, clenching the teeth increases the pain, and clenching on the separator also increases the pain. Similarly, stretching, clenching the teeth increases the pain, clenching on a separator increases the pain, but while opening the mouth there is no pain. Superior lateral pterygoid. So contraction by clenching the teeth or clenching on a separator increases the pain. While clenching on the teeth increases the pain, or with the help of a separator also increases the pain. But if you open the mouth, there is no pain. So medial pterygoid. Clenching the teeth increases the pain, or by clenching on a separator also increases the pain, but opening the mouth also increases the pain. So thereby you can test the medial pterygoid. So coming to the assignment, enumerate the muscles of mastication. Write in detail about the lateral pterygoid muscle, including its relation, masseter, temporalis, and medial pterygoid. So you should tell about the origin, insertion, nerve supply, and action of these muscles. Then boundaries and contents of infratemporal fossa, boundaries and contents of pterygopalatine fossa, digastric muscle.